When most people think of bees, they think of honeybees, and rightly so, because honeybees are the rock stars of bees. But did you know there's actually over 20,000 species of bees on the planet, and they range from just a fraction of an inch in size to well over an inch and a half? In North America alone, there's over 4,000 species of bees, and in Florida, there's over 315 species of bees. So what is all the buzz about bees? Bees are absolutely everywhere. In fact, at UF IFAS, we study bees and their contributions to man through their pollination of agricultural crops. Take these bees here, for example. We collected these on blueberry and watermelon fields in north central Florida, and this represents the great diversity of bees. We have bumblebees and carpenter bees and honeybees, among some other species. Now, a lot of people, when they see this, they would immediately think about the fact that bees sting. But most bees are very docile, and most people will never have a stinging encounter with bees. Bees are very important for us. We need them, in fact. But what do bees need? Bees need two main things to be successful. The first of those is food, and bees get all of their food from flowers. Now, flowers like these yield two foodstuffs that bees need. The first of those is pollen, which they will take back to their nest and give to their young. The second of those is nectar. Now, a lot of bees will mix nectar into their pollen to feed to their babies. Of course, honeybees take nectar and make honey out of it. Now, when bees are visiting all of these flowers, we benefit because it results in fruits and vegetables and nuts and berries because of the pollination efforts. So we get to enjoy all the hard work that the bees do on these flowers. Now, the second thing that all bees need is shelter. They must have a place to build a nest. And of those 20,000 bee species on the planet, 70% of them actually nest under our feet in the ground. Take a look at this bare ground here. You'll notice that there are some small holes that bees have created. Now, these holes lead to cavities or tunnels in the ground where the bees are actually rearing their offspring. About 30% of the 20,000 bee species nest in cavities. Of course, there are honeybees that have large colonies, so they have to nest in large cavities the size of basketballs or larger. But a lot of bees will actually nest in tunnels created in rotten wood by other insects or in tunnels in the pithy stems of certain plants. So one way that we can help bees is we can provide nesting habitat for them. For example, if you look here, you'll see that we have 2x4s that are untreated in which we drilled holes of different sizes. These different size holes accommodate bees of different sizes that will nest in these holes. We've also used bamboo stems. Bamboo is naturally hollow. You can provide bamboo of different sizes to attract different bees to nest in there. We've even provided floral resources for bees. Bees have to get the nectar and pollen from flowers, so we can look up flowers that grow well in our area that bees like and provide those flowers for the bees to use to provision their nest. We also need to watch the amount of pesticides that we use in and around the home, and certainly follow the label anytime you're using pesticides. Finally, you can join citizen science projects that promote bee health and bee education. For more information about bees, how they benefit us, and how we can help them, visit Solutions for Your Life.